Start now?
Yes, sir.
Good afternoon, everybody. We're into the first MIRDAS conference Philippines. My topic is about reinforced concrete structure using MIRDAS Gen, modeling to reinforcement detailing with bill of materials. Tenets of my presentations are a brief introduction, design constraints, case study of a 10-story reinforced concrete building, MIDA solutions for building information modeling, BIM, conclusions. Now to start with, most of our structural engineer into Dilimna, when we are in between what our client, the architect and the contractors want, so they expect us to act like magicians, okay, to produce the plans and the design documents, and most of the time up to the bill of materials. Now our usual design constraints are beam depth and location, column dimension and location, shear wall thickness and location, floor to floor height, material preferences, I mean the strength of concrete and usually the strength of steel, the foundation, which includes the soil bearing capacity, pile capacity, ground improvement necessary, and seismic design parameter, and of course the structural ratios, which I will go into discuss later on during this presentation. Now for the case study, we will present this project brief. It is a 20-story business processing outsourcing office located at BCTA, Taguig City. First, it was a 15-story building. Then the client decided to make it a 10-story building. The typical column-to-column distance is 11.5 meter. Typical floor-to-floor height is 4 meter. And typical girder size is 500 by 700, and typical column size is 800 by 800 millimeter. Elevator is at the building center. So the typical floor plan looks like this. You see the elevator shaft is at the middle of the building, therefore there is no torsional irregularities in our design. This is a typical elevation of the building. Okay. Now for this case study, the design criteria, we use the National Structural Code of the Philippines, NECP 2010, for the dead load, live load, wind load, seismic load, which include the static and the seismic load dynamic. For this project, it is regular. We do not have wind load tunnel study and site-specific seismic study. Now, for the design code, we use the NSCP 2010, 6th edition. For the material properties, for concrete strength, we were constrained by the contractor. They preferred to use 7,000 PSI. Pile cap foundation, we use 5,000 PSI. And for the reinforcing bars, we use 60 KSI for the main reinforcing bars and 40 KSI for the ties and stirrups. For the design loads, these are design loads that we use, no? Specifically, the slab thickness is about 5 inches. That's 100 PSF. And all these loads come from NSCP 2010. For the live loads, since it is a BPO office, the recommended live load for call centers or BPO office is 2.9 kilopascal, or it's equivalent to 60 PSF. The other loadings also came from NSCP 2010, such as for the lobbies, the IT room, and for the elevator, came from the manufacturer's specification. For the geotechnical evaluation, the highlight is the source, no? The project site is only about 3 to 4 kilometers from the nearest fault line, is the valley fault system, and it can generate a type A and B, seismic activity. Another highlight of the geotechnical evaluation is that the presence of liquefiable and highly compressible soil, therefore a bored pile or a driven pile is highly recommended. For the seismic load static, these are the parameters that we use. The highlight of which is that for the distance from the West Valley Fault System, it is only 3.3, we use only 3.3 kilometer, and the seismic source type is A. For the seismic load dynamic, we use the UBC 1997. For the wind load, we use IBC 2009 or ASCE 7-05, highlight of which is that the building is at zone 2, which has a maximum of 200 kilometers per hour wind velocity. Now for the 3D model, here we use Midas Gen, where you can take advantage of the 3D perspective walkthrough of Midas Gen while interacting with the architects during technical meetings. Okay, we can produce the 3D model view and the 3D wire view easily. Okay, then this is a typical floor model of the building, the 3D model which we generated automatically with Midas Gen. Take note that by providing intermediate beams in between columns and girders, we were able to minimize the slab thickness 225 millimeter or 5 inches. The loading were automatically generated using Midas, under the Midas Gen environment. So you see there that the loading there were put automatically with the Midas Gen environment. So this is a 3D model dynamic displacement animation. Okay, we suggest that you always do animation when you're under Midas Gen to make sure that the lateral load was prescribed properly in your 3D model. You see here the load is moving. So you are sure that the seismic load was properly in place on your 3D model. Now the beam design, we interlink the Midas Design Plus with the model to generate the beam design automatically. Here you can see that we were able to generate the beam sections. Okay, and take note here that the figure that you can see here already in DWG file, which can easily be exported to CAD file in to fit your title block. Now another option that we use in our design is by using D-Shop, which is more advantageous. Skip pula. But before that, no, when we are using Midas Design Plus to ensure that the design follows the ductility requirement. Okay, we check it against this figure, the spacing of ties, to check if it follows the ductility requirements. Okay, and export it to CAD drawings automatically to fit within your standard title block. Now using this Midas D-Shop, which is another option in the Midas package, you can easily interlink D-Shop from Midas Gen 3D model. You can export Midas Gen to Midas drawing file through MGN data file to link to D-Shop. With it, you can easily generate the building frame in CAD format. You can generate the beam sections, cross sections, in CAD format also. You can see the column sections at the ends of the center can easily be generated. And also, this is very important, using Midas D-Sharp, you can generate the longitudinal section of the beam with the bar cutting list, as you can see on the inset figure. Then column can also be designed using Midas Design Plus. You can easily generate the column cross section with the ties by automatically linking the Design Plus with your 3D structural model. The next option, which is more advantageous, is using. After that, you can check the ductility requirement using the provision of NSCP 2010 Section 421 for earthquake resistant design. Another option, okay, that is also for the spacing of the reinforcing bar. You can check with the Section 407.11.5.3 for the spacing. And this file, you can export it directly to your the CAD file to arrange it in within your standard title block. Another option is to use Midas D-Sharp, which is more convenient, more appropriate. Using Midas D-Sharp, again, you can easily export the Midas Gen model to Midas drawing file in MGN format to link to D-Sharp. By then, you can easily generate the column section in CAD format and put it directly into your standard office title block. Then you can arrange it. You can arrange the tie spacing manually. It has a facility to do it, okay, manually. Then this very advantageous for the ulitin ko lang. Papa, huwag ka pumaigi, nag-record kami. Mamaya, pasunday lang. Tapusin na namin. Ulitin ko na lang. Okay. Then, Jim, huwag ka muna namin nag-record kami, Jim. Dali lang, ha. Editin mo na lang, Shira. Pabi na kayo mag-critic. Then, the longitudinal section of the column can also be generated showing all the cutting length for the longitudinal bar as well as the column ties. Take note that all the beam and column details follows the ACI 315 provision. So this is the reference used by Midas for all the drawing shop ACI 315. Now for the shear wall analysis, we use Midas Gen in doing the analysis. As you can see in this specific project, the ground floor is highly stressed. You can see at the right, at the red encircled portion. Okay, we were able to link Design Plus with Midas Gen to generate automatically the stresses and produce the shear wall schedule in CAD drawing format automatically. For the foundation analysis, we were able to generate the reactions, support reaction during Midas, using Midas Gen, then link it with the Design Plus design facility for foundation design. We use it to design the pile cap. Automatically generates the dimension, the footing dimension, and the pile cap reinforcement design in CAD drawing file. And with that, you can easily export it to the your standard title block drawings. Now, for the bill of material, for this project, we use first the Midas Gen facility for the bill of material. As you can see, you can generate the total volume of concrete for all the columns and beams. Then the total volume of concrete for the shear wall. And after that, we have another option. for this project, wherein we use Midas D-Shop to generate all the concrete volumes and the area or kilogram weight of steel and the total area of the form system. Take note that we use two options here because Midas D-Shop is the later development of Midas IT, which we believe better than working with Midas Design Plus when it comes to producing bill of materials and detailing. Now for this specific project, this is the actual calculation for the design ratios that was produced by the construction project manager. The highlighted one are the computed ratios. Okay. Now for concrete, the computed ratio is 0.36 cubic meter per square meter of floor area, and using our design, using Midas Gen and B-Shop and Design Plus, we were able to produce 0.4. I'm reading ko. Using these computed design ratios, the actual computed ratios are highlighted, wherein we use Midas Gen and Midas D-Shop. For the concrete, we were able to, in our design, the computed design ratio is 0.36 cubic meter per square meter floor area. The standard drains ratio set expected by the client is in between 0.4 to 0.53. Therefore, our design ratio is within what is expected by the client for the concrete. And for the rebars, our computed design ratio is 225.54 kilogram per cubic meter of concrete, and the standard ratios per client is in between 180 to 310 kilogram per cubic meter. So still, we are, our design is within what is expected by the client. And for the formworks, the our design computed is 1.71 square meter of form system to square meter of floor area, and the expected standard ratio is 2 to 3.0. So you can see here that our design fit what is expected by the project manager or our client. Midas solution for Midas building information management. 3D modeling can be done by Midas Gen and alternatively by AutoCAD, ZWCAD or Tekla. Structural analysis and design can be done by Midas Gen, while design drawings and BOM can easily be generated by Midas Design Plus, and more conveniently through Midas D-Shop. Now with us using Midas Gen for the past 5 years, we get unparalleled service says from Midas IT, summarized as they give us one of the best technical support, which includes online chat, on-demand meetings, immediate help desk. Then they can give accessible technical material through tutorials, manuals, and FAQ, and ultimate technical training through 24-hour session technical service program, monthly webinar, and international seminars like this that we're having right now. This is an actual picture of our consultation with Midas technical people in our office during actual project meeting. Then this manual can be downloaded through their 24/7 online manual. Now we found Midas solution for BAM very effective in this kind of irregular project which we have right now in Baguio City, Philippines. It's actually a Hyundai showroom which we use Midas D-Shop to generate the framing and the rebar layout automatically. You see here, you have the floor framing plan and the bar cutting list automatically generated using Midas D-Shop. and we can easily email it to our client right after we produce it. These are the actual transmittal of plant to our client in Baguio City, which took us only 2 to 3 days to generate for that very irregular structures. You see that in this screen, you can see the actual rebar layout of a beam showing their actual cutting list. These are the columns. So the conclusion, accurate and fast design solution for building information modeling or BIM will keep us at pace to industry standard. We can optimize design of RC buildings, can meet the demands of the architect, the contractor, and the client businessman, but never compromise public safety. And it will be a challenge to Midas IT Philippines to remain responsive to the needs of the Filipino engineers, considering periodic NSCP updates. With that, thank you very much.